Joe Pratt. I'm here in West Columbia, South Carolina, at the Airport High School. As you can see, the seating capacity is very minimal. They're even turning people away at the front door because even got tickets. Luckily, I knew a security guy, and he kind of showed me how to get in here, so there we go. Anyway, President Trump is going to come out and do a little speech. And as you know, Governor Masters is running for governor, and he is going to do a speech in his honor. So there we go. As you see, this is a high school stadium, folks. And a guy that's driving here disagreed with the way they are doing the seating capacity. They don't even have seats. Look at the people sitting on the floor. I mean, there's people outside. There's probably about 100 people outside with tickets. When I got here, they're standing in line, and they were selling them out front from school that it's packed and you can't get in, even with tickets. But luckily, a friend of mine came by. He's working security here. He told me to follow it, so I went right toward the bag, and they let me in. But thank God he was here. Never got in. But I feel sorry for those folks like me that ordered their tickets in advance and they still won't let them in. And any of you who sees this video, you're not telling the truth. The ones that ordered their tickets and got their tickets, printed out tickets, they're turning them down. And that's wrong. They would have turned me down also if I didn't. I don't want to scare the guy.
Thank you, sir.
Man, they're playing Elton John. This is old Elton singing that Rocket Man. But I'm right here in West Columbia, South Carolina. The airport studio, airport high school. This is their gymnasium here. As you can see, people, it's almost packed. There's people sitting in the floor. And they only probably have room, probably maybe another 100 people, and that'd be probably about it. They'll cut them off. What they should do, if you look straight ahead yonder, that's open. They should go up front and let those people in that's got tickets to get in, let them come here and sit there. I mean, that's very wrong. June the 25th, 2018, and they're supposed to start it up here about 6 p.m. I'm assuming Governor McMaster come out first, and then Trump will come out with him. Security is very, very tight, which it should be. There was three police officers scanned me about four times. And they missed two batteries that I had in my pocket, two backup batteries, you know, for this camera here. And the batteries have metal inside of them that it didn't go off. I started to pull the batteries out, let you see them, but I didn't. But I just go to show you. The metal detector don't pick up all metal. They really don't want you bringing in video cameras, like when I got here, cell phones. I told the guy, one of guys, I said, hey, well, look. He said, though, man, you can't bring that in, really. I said, man, I have to go all the way back out to my motorcycle and put it up, and I don't want anybody stealing it, man, because they'll go in my couch and steal it out. He said, well, go on. And I was not out there in doing that. So, thanks to him, y'all. I said, if I can't get his picture of him or video as I go out, so thanks to him, I'm getting to do this video. I mean, they don't mind if you carry, you know, bring your phone in, because it's a video on the phone, but what I've got an actual I got quite quick, didn't they?
Yeah. We come before you today humbly asking for your presence with and your mercies and blessings on the Governor and First Lady. In particular, we ask that you would uphold Governor McMaster as he showed us the burden of executive government. You have entrusted to him the sacred and noble vocation of furthering the rule of law and much else in this great state of South Carolina. We acknowledge that righteousness and justice are the foundation of your throne, that your own character is the transcendent source of law and justice, that your law is the fountainhead of all legitimate human law and rights. Thank you, Lord, for our governor. Bless him and his staff as he seeks re-election as governor and further seek ways to serve you in our state in the coming years. Grant that the governor would lead with energy, integrity, and by example. Grant to Governor McMaster and all who work with him and for him the desire and wisdom of Solomon to discern between good and evil. Make their motives to be in all their decisions the promotion of justice, the protection of the weak, and the advancement of the public good. Give them hearts to labor on behalf of the impoverished and destitute, but to show bias neither to rich nor poor. Teach them to love both mercy and justice. Cause them to adorn the vocation of civil government by their own practice of it, and to raise the public estimation of its importance and integrity, and to assist in securing the continuation of a just and equitable society. Shield the governor from the peculiar temptations of his office, and use him not only for the promotion of our people's economic well-being, but also their moral well-being, so that through him, the longing of the ancient prophet would be realized, that justice would roll down like waters and righteousness like an ever-flowing stream. We also pray for the citizens of the great state of South Carolina that you would grant them wisdom and discernment in the exercise of their democratic franchise, according to a promise that if anyone lack wisdom, they should ask of God who gives liberally. God bless the governor of the state of South Carolina. God bless the President of the United States of America. This I ask in Jesus' name. Yes. Amen.
Please remain standing for the presentation of college on the Airport High School Junior ROTC.
running for office. He came down, let me tell you this story.
Boo.
Let me tell you this story. He rode down 95. You know where South of the border is, right? He called off there to Dillon, and he went to a little schoolie little girl in the back, and he said, this is the corridor change. Remember that? You remember that? What did he do about it?
Nothing.
Nothing. You know, government master Donald Trump just opened the Dillon Inland Port right in the middle of those three poor counties. Before it opened, it created 1,100 jobs. It'll create 3,000 jobs in the next 5 years. They don't talk. They deliver. They don't talk.
Yeah.
South Carolina loves you.